Bonjour. Tonight is the first day actually where we had a storm in San Francisco for the season, and it seemed to have been quite a mess outside. Water is good, remember? We need a lot of water, way more, and it needs to go inside of the earth to be able to feed it. So we need more water, and we should ask for more water actually in California. That being said, this post is going to be on colors because some nice lady on Twitter, Tamra, asked me to talk about colors and the influence of colors in feng shui and on the life of the people. Therefore, I'm going to talk about colors. Colors have a huge influence on life, and I am probably one of the most anti-beige person you would find. Not that I never use beige, but that most of the time the way beige is used in this country specifically is absolutely not supporting the life of the beings inside. A lot of people go for beige because they don't know what else to use, or because it's safe, what actually comes back to the first reason, or because also they think it's neutral enough so they can marry it, match it, or whatever they say, with everything else. They usually don't end up matching it with anything else, and they put it usually with more beige. If you put a beige that is a yellowish beige in your home, it turns into what some people call earthy tones, what I would call a dirty tone, and in that case it will just be too muddy to support life. When you look at life, when you look at nature, you look at the plants, you look at the animals, look at everything that is growing. How are the colors? They are strong colors. They are bright red, they are bright purple, they are bright blue, they are bright yellow, they are bright black, because they are also dull black, but they are bright black. Life is not beige. Life is bright. Therefore, if you want to introduce life in your home, and if you want your home to support your life, and when I say your home, it's also your office. I work with a lot of offices, and it's very, very important to support the energy, the productivity, the creativity, the harmony inside of the offices, especially now with the times that are quite complicated when people do three jobs in one and see their friends leaving every day. So it's important to keep this harmony, and for keeping this harmony, you need to actually increase the level of brightness, energy. If you want something really, really, really dull, go for as many earth tones as you want. But if you want something that is actually embracing you, in that case, do accents of colors. I don't tell you to paint the whole house bright red or bright orange. God forbid, that would be unlivable. And I remember my parents a long time ago had painted the toilets actually in France in the bright orange. We could not keep the door closed. We stayed 24 hours with the orange bright toilets, and then we repainted it after. It was a great experiment. But so don't do the whole thing bright, all the walls, but do accents of brightness, exactly like life. And don't worry, you don't have to match anything, you don't have to blend anything. You just want an harmony of tones, an harmony of inputs, an harmony of parcels that makes your life full. That's not more difficult than that. Then, if you want something more subtle, that's not a problem. You can use grays. I love grays. Grays are so chic. I'm doing actually right now a bedroom with gray tones. with the purple undertones, and it is absolutely sophisticated and beautiful. But I put accents of colors in the curtains, in the chairs, on the bed, and my grays are not dirty grays. They are not earthy grays. They are pure grays. Very, very, very pure grays. And that is gorgeous. Voilà. That was my small take. Of course, I'm Parisian, so earth tones, not so much. We'll talk about that later again. And we'll talk about the cycles of colors. We can use earth tones, but put them outside of your house more than inside of your home. Okay? Au revoir. Paint well. Namaste. Shit.